right, everybody, we are approaching Clewiston, Florida. All around us are sugarcane and orange plantations, and there's also a lot of sod. So if you have grass on your yard here in Florida, it probably came from this region here. Here we're 27 and 80 meet. 27 goes north and 80 goes towards the east. There's a new bridge that was built. We're gonna go over the bridge and head into Clewiston. That is the sugarcane. It's the life of Clewiston. It's the sugarcane. It provides work that doesn't really pay well, but work for the city of Clewiston. That right there, the sugarcane. This is the sugarcane, guys. The yellow sugarcane. There's also purple sugarcane. This is the yellow variety. Dog fighting is a crime. Yeah, dog fighting is unfortunately a popular thing here. They are interested in finding dog fighters. Last time we were out here, this was open, but was it? Can't remember. Funny that there's a papaya tree right there with fruit on it next to this abandoned, I guess it was a hotel.
Hooker's Point.
Thank you.
Alright, y'all, I've seen some impressive trees in Florida. But this tree in Clewiston, are you kidding me, bro? Look at that tree. It's gotta be 6 foot across diameter, all the way up to about 3 stories high, then it gets to like 4 to 5 feet. Dude. Wow. What an impressive plant, man. And the house that sits on the property is impressive itself, but the tree, my goodness. Look at that. That's just incredible. And there's two of them. There's that one, and then there's this one. It's just incredible. Absolutely incredible, y'all. That's your house?
Yeah.
It's a cute little house.
Well, I mean, we're renting it, but still, we're in front of
it's
house.
It's cute. How old is it?
Huh?
You know how old it is?
1940.
40s? Wow. Yeah, I think maybe somebody killed him. Definitely somebody killed him for a religious sacrifice. Okay, so these two chickens met at a very unfortunate end. Well, this was from a sugarcane mill, and it was donated to the Museum of Clewiston here. Now, I talked to the people that had the little incident with the chicken on their lawn, and they said if they called the cops, it would take about 2 days for the cops to actually come. So, for 2 days for the cops to show up, so... These were items that were donated to the Museum of Clewiston from some of the sugarcane production. It's a beautiful part of the Clewiston's history here on display for everybody to enjoy. So whoever donated these things, it's a really great thing they did by sharing these artifacts with pretty much everybody. As you can hear the trains going, sugarcane is an important aspect of this town's history. I love how they would write, still clearly read after so many years, the companies that made these artifacts. So it's a very nice thing to have here in town. Just love it. I mean, when you like to have this on your front lawn, just a nice little thing that they've done by having this here. And I guess it's engraved into the concrete as a permanent way of making sure that it doesn't disappear one day. Amazing piece of history here. Large engine. Here's a piece of something. Check this bad boy out. Wow. How's that? How's that for some chunk of metal? This little strip right here seems to be the main thoroughway of the town. And we have a nice little historic district here, which appears to be Bond Street. This is the main strip here of Clewiston, guys. Big chunk of metal. Now it is a Sunday, so it's no surprise that everything's closed in a small town. It'd be nice to see what type of life is here on a tomorrow morning. Not surprising that a small town's dead on a Sunday afternoon. It's kind of what you'd expect. Unless you're in Alabama, then this is what a small town looks like on a Monday morning. Alright guys, so we're gonna get something to eat here in Clewiston, Florida. I like this little place, Cafe Tropical. It's a little Cuban place I like. It's nothing special, but it's right here on the main road, and we like it, and we're gonna get some Cuban food. Recommended by Katie, who lied to me about restaurant ratings so she could go to the one she wanted.
What?
Yeah?
What?
Okay? No hablo español, señora. $8.50 for an entree, that's not bad.
Yeah.
That is the palomilla steak.
Katie's got hers. We got some coffee with milk, and then that's Katie's rice and beans.
Straight up. That's the end of the trip here in Clewiston. I hope you guys like it. If you watch the entire video and you're not subscribed, subscribe.
Subscribe immediately.
Immediately now.